രാജശ്രീ വെങ്കിട്ടരമണൻ 130 വാക്ക് ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ഷോർട്ട് ആൻഡ് സ്പീഡ് ഡിക്റ്റേഷനാണ് വായിക്കുന്നത്. ഈ യൂട്യൂബ് ചാനലിൽ ധാരാളം ഫ്രേസസ് ഷോർട്ട് ടിക്സ് ഒക്കെ ഞാൻ അപ്ലോഡ് ചെയ്തിട്ടുണ്ട്. പ്ലേലിസ്റ്റിൽ നോക്കിയാൽ കാണാൻ സാധിക്കും. ഞങ്ങൾ അതും കൂടി പഠിക്കുക. മിസ്റ്റർ പ്രസിഡന്റ്, വൈസ് ചാൻസലർ, ഡിസ്റ്റിംഗ്വിഷ് ഡെലിഗേറ്റ്സ്, ലേഡീസ് ആൻഡ് ജെന്റിൽമാൻ, ഐ ആം ഇൻഡീഡ് മോസ്റ്റ് ഹാപ്പി ടു ബി ഇൻ യുവർ മിഡ്സ്റ്റ് ടുഡേ ആൻഡ് ടു ഹാവ് ബീൻ അക്കോർഡഡ് ദ പ്രിവിലേജ് ഓഫ് ഇനാഗുറേറ്റിംഗ് ദ 5th കൺവെൻഷൻ ഓഫ് ദ ഇന്ത്യൻ അഗ്രികൾച്ചറൽ യൂണിവേഴ്സിറ്റീസ് അസോസിയേഷൻ. ദ വെന്യൂ ഹാസ് ഇൻഡീഡ് ബീൻ വെൽ ചോസൺ ഓവർ ദ സെഞ്ചുറീസ്. തിരുപ്പതി വാസ് അട്രാക്റ്റഡ് മില്യൺസ് ഓഫ് പീപ്പിൾ ഫ്രം ഓൾ ഓവർ ഇന്ത്യ who have come here as a mark of their devotion to the Lord. In recent years, the town has grown into an important center of learning and education. This pilgrim center has served as a focus of national integration and has been symbolic of emotional unity of India. I have great pleasure in welcoming you to this place of pilgrimage, and I'm sure that its congenial environment and its ennobling atmosphere will help you to bring to bear on your deliberations not only a practical approach to the problems facing you and the country, but also a long-range perspective for the enduring happiness of humanity. If the venue of the convention is appropriate, so is the time. We are now on the threshold of the 5th 5-year plan. After a fairly lengthy spell of indifferent seasons, nature this year has been relatively kind to us. In Andhra Pradesh itself, during the 4th plan period, we have had 3 severe droughts and 2 major cyclones. It is only this year that conditions have been generally normal. Let us hope that the weather gods will be kind to us in the coming years also. But it behooves us also to be prepared for all eventualities and to see that the country's human resources are utilized to the maximum advantage to secure the greatest benefit from a given environment. It is in this context that the role of the Indian agricultural universities becomes more significant. It is now nearly 15 years since the first university was established. I understand that there are now 20 agricultural universities in the country. I'm sure some more will be started in the coming years. There is no doubt that their role in the national planning for agriculture has now come to be recognized. The concept of the agricultural university was evolved essentially from the need to establish an effective instrument for providing an integrated system of research, education and extension in agriculture and allied fields. There is no doubt that over 10 years they have made a significant contribution to improve in all its aspects the agricultural technology in the country. This, however, is not time for complacency. Whatever may be our achievements in the past and however successful may have been the Green Revolution, it is clear that we have still a long way to go in the matter of increasing our agricultural production. The last few years have shown how, in spite of sizable buffer stocks, the country had to face severe shortages in food grains availability as a result of the poor monsoon. It is essential for our survival that we should build up in the coming few years an agricultural base that is wide enough and strong enough to sustain us through years of scanty rainfall and help us to do away with the need to import food grains altogether. This indeed is the paramount need of the hour. There is, of course, plenty of scope for improvement. Our yields are still low in comparison with these attained by developed and some developing countries. This is a measure of the productivity gap that has to be bridged. The fifth plan, no doubt, envisages a substantial increase in the productivity of our principal crops. It will be a test of our skills and ingenuity to achieve this and tribute to our enterprise if we surpass them.